FTG Legos and Gaming here, and today I'm going to be doing something different. Today I'm going to be breaking down the Stranger Things 3 official trailer. And so seeing as the new trailer comes out tonight, I decided to, I was going to upload this video on July 4th, but I thought I'd upload it today because of the new trailer coming out. So without further ado, let's get into this and get started.
At least someone's happy I'm home.
Alright, so the trailer starts off with Dustin coming home, setting down his bag, and his green clothes are actually clothes from a summer camp that he went to, and I assume that it is a month-long summer camp, depending on when his school gets out, because this takes place in July. And so, I can't really read the title of his camp, but it does appear to be like a sort of tech science camp. And the song he plays is Home Sweet Home by Motley Crue, and it's actually pretty cool that he plays this song, and I'll explain that in a moment right now. And so the next thing that happens is suddenly his toys start moving and they move into the living room. And so what was cool about the song choice is one, you know, he's coming home from the camp. But another thing is that one of the lyrics is, you know, I'm a dreamer. And Dustin even says himself,
you're dreaming.
And so as Dustin reaches the living room, we move past all the main characters. Max, Lucas, Will, Mike, and Eleven. And they all know they're smiling because, you know, they're pranking Dustin here with the whole thing. And Eleven was the one that was making the toys move in the first place. And this part is just hilarious because Dustin, he gets scared by everyone. And so this makes him, he sprays Lucas with some pepper spray. And it looks like it hurt. Alright, so the song that we hear for the entirety of the trailer from now on is Baba O'Reilly by The Who. And so this is actually a really catchy song. I actually really like it. And so it does give this 80s / summer vibe for the trailer, and that's kind of what they were going for, I think. Out here in the fields. So our next shot and the first lyric of Baba O'Reilly is Out Here in the Fields. And I mean, it's pretty simple for this shot because, you know, they're literally in a field. And so what we see next is they appear to be setting up some sort of satellite. And that's probably if you remember in season 1 and 2, that machine they had from Mr. Clark, this is probably like something similar. They're trying to do some sort of radio thing like that. Alright, now we see the Hawkins Post. And so that's the newspaper of the town and, you know, the American flag. As Ted says, we're all patriots here. And at the Hawkins Post, we find Nancy and Jonathan teaming up again. It appears they're probably going to be interviewing to be at the Post, or they're going to deliver a story and they work there now. Another interesting thing here is the lyric that plays while we move towards them, and that is, I fight for my meals. And so what this could mean is that Nancy and Jonathan, they're probably fighting for the people of the town. You know, they're very kind people and they want to get the truth out there, so it's quite possible that this lyric is hinting at a story they're trying to do is probably to help someone or uncover some sort of secret right here in Hawkins once more. And next we see Billy working as a lifeguard now, and you know, the girls seem to be into him because, I mean, you know, who wouldn't like an abusive brother, you know what I'm saying? My boy, Jim Hopper, about to go on a date in a fancy clothes. He's still smoking. At a fancy restaurant, he's still smoking. And what I think's going to happen here, or was going to happen, is that he was going to go out on a date with Joyce. And what seems to be happening here is she didn't go. And I actually have some theories why she didn't want to go. So the biggest theory I have as to why Joyce didn't go out with Hopper, if he even asked her out, is Bob. And this is the one that makes the most sense out of my two theories. And it's because, I mean, you watch his death the first time, it's like, oh, Bob died. You watch it over and over. I've watched it a lot of times already, just because I've rewatched season 2 over and over. And, like, it's so impactful. Like, he was actually a good guy. Joyce loved him. And, you know, they cared for each other. And then he just dies so brutally. And I don't think, even though it's a year later, I don't think she's fully recovered from this. And so I don't think she's ready to move on from Bob. She moved on from Lonnie because he was a jerk. But Bob, you know, he was actually a really good guy. And to see him die like this, I just don't think that she's ready to move on from Bob in a relationship, and that's why she doesn't want to go out with Hopper, if he even asked her out in the first place. And so my second theory is, I prefer the Bob one, but this one is, it's pretty practical. They've known each other since high school, and they were good friends, and so I think that if Jim did ask her out, she didn't go with him because she didn't want to ruin their friendship, because, you know, she didn't want to ruin the good friendship that they had, that they've had since high school. And, you know, you see this in movies and stuff, and some TV shows, like a friend asks out another friend, and, you know, it gets weird sometimes. And so I'm guessing she just didn't want that. And that actually makes a lot of practical sense, but I personally prefer the Bob one because it makes more sense, to be honest.
We're not kids anymore. I mean, what did you think? We're just gonna sit in my basement all day? Play games for the rest of our lives?
And so this next part is very important, and I can actually relate to pretty much all of it. And it's been said before that the characters here, they're gonna face a lot more teenage problems now. And all the stuff that we see in this bit, it's related to growing up. And I mean, Mike Wheeler, literally on wheels, lays it out front for us.
We're not kids anymore. I mean, what did you think? We're just gonna sit in my basement all day, play games for the rest of our lives?
And so this could be that he's just growing up and all that. But I think that he personally feels a little bit of anger, maybe sadness, because they're leaving from the buyer's house and it appears empty. There's no chairs, there's no car. So I think the buyers might be moving, or at least thinking of moving in this season. And Mike isn't the only one departing from the buyer's house. We see Lucas, and I believe Will, and at the very end, Dustin leaving as well. Max and Eleven are finally hanging out, being good friends over the summer. Next, we move on to Dustin, and Dustin, I honestly feel really bad for him. He's my favorite character, and in this specific shot, he's sad because he missed his chance with Max, and now Max is going out with Lucas. And, you know, he just feels bad about it. Alright, so this next part is a lot of Easter eggs, and it's actually really important, and this goes into what I've been talking about growing up and everything. Alright, so one of the first items we see here is a jar, and it's empty, but it either says bowl on it, or this is a mason jar. And this right here, I'm not gonna lie, I really don't know what it is. It looks like some sort of stick or a handle, but I really don't know what it is. Maybe some makeshift nunchucks. Next, we have a miniature tank that looks similar to Dustin's. There's another jar, and there's actually a jack piece. And I hope you know what jack is, but it's a bigger version of that. Alright, so whoever made this must really like jars, because there's another jar here. There's actually a bottle next to it. So it's a little hard to read what's on it, but this bottle is crushed, and it says composition, possibly guard, and Cincinnati. What this could be is like a nutrition drink or something. There's another, you guessed it, jar. Well, it's more of a container, but it looks like a jar, and it looks to be mixed nuts inside. In the far back, there's a box. It looks to be holding either some sort of doll or fabric or drawing in there. Moving on to more recognizable stuff, there's a picture of the gang from season 2 in their Ghostbusters costumes. This one's super interesting. So this is the picture from season 1 where Mike was showing Eleven his room, and this is the science fair where they got second place. Now, what's interesting about this is the picture frame. On the top of the frame, we can read Will the Wise, which is Will's nickname in Dungeons and Dragons. If we turn it sideways, on the right, it can be seen Lucas the Knight. On the very bottom, it's hard to read because of the lighting, but it actually says Dustin the Dwarf. And the left side is even harder to read, but DM at the very end, this is Mike Dungeon Master. And so my personal theory about what this whole thing is that it is actually a sort of shrine of remembrance to Will, when everyone thought he was dead. And so it has some of his favorite things. There's toys, which are obviously his. That bottle there, it's probably like one of his favorite drinks or a drink that he had. These jars, probably jars that he just had as collectibles. The nuts, probably his favorite food. And it's just surrounded by things that he liked. And so this was a shrine to him. And so bringing it back to the whole growing up thing, I think that Will is sad here because they're growing up. Things are different now. And this can also go into how I think that the buyers are going to be moving in the season. Like, they're planning to move to Maine, like Bob had suggested. And so, if they're moving, he's sad because he's going to be leaving his friends behind. And that's why Mike is all sad and angry as well. And so, I believe that him crying here in the woods at night, he's just sad about everything, and it's going to end soon. Alright, so things get happy here. Dustin and Joe, they're hanging out at Ahoy, and we see the new Starcourt Mall, which is loaded by the mayor. Max and Eleven are hanging out there. And so here we see people protesting. So obviously a lot of people don't like the mayor. And they have signs saying things like Mayor Swine, support downtown. They're basically just calling him mean names and all that. And so he also built a fun fair. And so it seems that the people might not like the mayor because he's just doing things like to gain money, kind of like the mayor from Jaws. And we see here a guy in the mirror room, and I'm really getting like a Terminator type vibe from him.
I want you to feel like this can still be your home.
And now we see Hopper, and he's telling Joyce, I want you to feel safe. I want you to feel like this can still be your home. So I think what he's trying to do here is convince her to stay in Hawkins and just stay with him pretty much, and Will with his friends. Alright, so here we see more of Eleven at the beach, as most people do during the summer. And what's interesting is behind her, if you can see, is a red lightning storm. And what was the last thing we saw related to a red lightning storm? The Mind Flayer. That means that he's still around, and he's still relevant, and he's coming back. Alright, so after we see Eleven here on the beach, she is back in the void, and she trips on a what looks to be a bathtub and then drowns. And so I think this is related to a later shot where we see a lifeguard drowning underwater. All right, we see Billy again, and so something's off. He's in a shower, right? But on his arm is something. And so there's a clip, or a very short clip released recently, where he's driving and his car gets hit by something, and that could be a creature. And so a theory is that infected Billy turns into this thing that we see at the end of the trailer. And that could be very possible, all things considered. Alright, next, there's Mike and everyone else, what looks to be inside the mall. Lucas is on his left, Will is on his right, and at the very bottom, which is technically the back, you can see Max right there. Next, we see what looks to be Dustin, Steve, and the new character Robin sliding down the escalator. Eleven pushes the doors open to what seems to be the hospital that we see at the end of the trailer. And she's followed by the whole gang. Will, Lucas, Max, Mike, and Dustin, which he can be seen in the far back. So some people in some form of hazmat suits are brutally attacked by lightning from a machine. And I believe this machine is from the Hawkins Labs people trying to reopen the gate once more. Next, we see Lucas's younger sister, Erica, with, like, well, looks to be pretty much battle gear, and she's climbing through the vents, and this could either be the hospital or Starcourt Mall. And finally, what is probably my favorite part of this entire trailer is the entire gang, minus Joyce and Hopper. We have Jonathan, Nancy, Lucas, Will, there's Max over there, the new character Robin, Mike, Eleven, and her nose is bleeding on both nostrils. That's only ever happened when she closed the gate. Dustin and Steve, who is beat up again. Some calm, and then the mayor wishes everyone a happy 4th of July, and bam! Whoo boy, there's a lot to break down, so let's break it down. Alright, first off, we have a bunch of rats, and they appear to be in a dirt, maybe even a barn based on the color of the ground, or maybe in just the forest. And so they all appear to be going one direction, and they could be guided by maybe the shadow monster. Alright, next we see Jake Bussy, I'm sorry, I don't know how to say his name, character. His name is Bruce, and he looks to be under a trance, and his bottom jaw, it appears to be like a sort of greenish-yellowish hue. And so I think he's under control of something, and again, probably the Mind Flayer. Next up is Steve, Dustin, Erica, and Robin, and behind them is either a bar, a place to hang out, or maybe even an arcade inside the mall. And if you've seen the reflection, there's some sort of light, or maybe some sort of panels on the top. And what they appear to be looking at is something blue, based on the lighting. Now we move on to Eleven doing her thing. She's connecting to the void through her blindfold, and I think she's probably using static in the lights and maybe even the refrigerator somehow behind her, and she's near the Eggos, obviously. Now, this looks like the exact same mall that she crashed the doors to in the first season, and the mall we see in a later shot. Alright, we got Hopper by a giant tiger, and he looks to be holding the same pistol about from the Terminator guy from earlier, And so he probably got the upper hand and took his gun, which is cool. Right, so this one is an interesting one. So this looks like the same lighting of that portal machine we saw earlier. And this looks like the beam coming out of it. And I think the red is it's burning into something. And this is either the wall of something, or it can be the roof of that building that the people are in. So this is one of many of these moments in between the quick shots. And this is the creature that we see at the end of the trailer rising up and growing. Next quick shot is Lucas, and he is pulling back and loading up the wrist rocket. And we see the brick behind him, and the red lighting in the back means that's probably an exit sign. So I think that he's at the hospital as well. Next up is Nancy, and she looks absolutely terrified. And see the lighting, and we also know this from the final shot. She's actually in the hospital right now, and the reaction on his face is she's reacting to the creature that is formed later on. And she looks absolutely terrified, and I would be too. And now this is possibly Billy, and I think this because the veins, the black veins that are forming in his eyes, I think that's whatever what is on his arm, it's spreading throughout his body. And now we see the close-up of it spreading through his eye and to just over all of them. Beast Rising 2, Electric Boogaloo. Alright, so we see Terminator Guy, and I'm sorry I couldn't find what his actor name or his character name is, forgive me. But we see him, and he now has a machine gun, and his surroundings, they look like some sort of underground place. And so he's shooting at something. It could be a creature, or it could be a person that he's hunting. We see another shot of Eleven and Max hanging out, and I really like this because, you know, Eleven was mad at Max in the second season, but I think it's really awesome to see them friends and just hanging out at the mall. I think it's super cool. Alright, so we're at the fair, and things look to be going a little chaotic. And so we see two people. The one on the left is named Winnie. The one on the right is named Heather. And so they really look like they're hypnotized or they're on some form of trance. And so I still think that the Mind Flayer is somehow controlling people now. And this maybe could be by the rats. And so they're being controlled to do something right here. The Rising 3, aka the Elongation. Right, so next is Steve, and he's in a lot of pain. I feel really bad for him. He's bleeding from the nose. He has a black eye. On top of that, he's getting injected with something. And the darkness behind him looks like he's in the same hospital. And it seems like maybe the last episode or second to last episode is going to take place in that hospital, and there's going to be a big thing about it, too. Joyce is holding Hopper's hand as they're running through the fair. They're either trying to go somewhere, or they're being chased. And I think that Terminator guy is chasing after them, and they're his target. Alright, so we have another shot of Eleven in the void, and she's wearing the same shirt from the earlier shot, where she's in that mart by the Eggos. And so, I think that she's tipping here, she's falling back. So this either represents her mental state, like her mind is somehow falling backwards, or someone's pushing her and trying to disrupt her connection with the void. Alright, so we have this car here, this long car, and I don't really recognize it, but this could be the buyer's car. And by the size of it, it could fit a lot of people, so I think it's either Eleven and someone else, because this looks like a mart, and the colors look the same as to where she was earlier. And so either someone or someone and a bunch of her friends are going to the mart so she can access the void, as we saw earlier. Alright, so now we see Will, and he appears to be in the same foresty area that we saw earlier when he was crying. And if you notice on his shoulder, on his neck, the sort of orangey lighting, that is from that little shrine thing. And the rain, it shows that we're in the exact same place, even the shirt from earlier. Alright, we get a return of Murray from season 2. He's the conspiracy theorist about all the Russians and everything. And he's screaming and he's wailing his arms. He's in an undershirt, his hair is waving. And I think that he's also a target of Terminator Guy. And he helped take down Hawkins' lab. And so Terminator Guy might be part of Hawkins' lab, and that's why he's hunting Murray down for revenge. Alright, next we see a female lifeguard, and this is probably the same lifeguard that we saw earlier walking past Billy. And this is probably the Case of the Missing Lifeguard episode, and we see Eleven here, and she's looking down at her as she's drowning, and she's either simply just drowning, or something or someone is taking her. Alright, here we are. The last quick shot is of Eleven, and she's wearing that same white and black shirt, and she's at her house, or her and Hopper's house, and she's angry here. And this is either like the season finale and something goes down, or she's just purely angry at Hopper, but I'd like to think that something is going to go down at that house. That brings us to one of the last shots, and that is the creature forming. Jonathan is at the very back, Nancy's at the top corner, and boy oh boy, does this creature look different than anything we've seen. and doesn't look creepy, but it also looks super awesome. And I still think that this is Billy, and he's just mutated, and I can't get over about how cool and creepy and awesome it looks.
How many children are you friends with?